have been talking about creating scatter plots and looking at different trends within the scatter plot so that we can determine what kind of association is being used. Positive, negative, no association. Also, we looked at linear versus non-linear scatter plots. So what we're going to look at today is a trend line. So a trend line, we drew a couple of these the other day, is a line that closely fits the data in a scatter plot. When we talked about these before, we talked about weak correlation versus strong correlation. So there are three things that we need to keep in mind when we draw a trend line. And we're going to cut this in half and do these in our journal. So first thing that we need to keep in mind when drawing a trend line is we need to get as close to each data point as possible. Now, we're not going to be able to go through every single one because it's a scatter plot, but we need to get as close as possible. We need to have about the same number of points on each side of the line. And then finally, the third thing is we need to go through at least 2 points if possible. Okay, so we're gonna practice doing that, and you're gonna need you can use a regular ruler, or I've got a clear ruler so I can kind of see where my dots are in relation to my line. One of the misconceptions that the trend line has to go through the origin. The trend line does not have to go through the origin. So if I am looking, I can go through probably this right here. And it's an estimate line. Alright. And I can see I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, pretty far away. These are kind of outliers. So that'll work. It needs to be as pretty much as close as you possibly can get it. And then we can do a couple of things with this. What kind of correlation do we see? Well, this is a linear positive correlation. These are pretty close, not super close. So you could make a defense for strong or weak, but remember next year we're going to be looking in the calculator to find that specificness. Let's agree on what we've already drawn our trend line. We're not going to write an equation of a trend line. We'll do that next year. Use the trend line. This is the important piece. Use the trend line to determine how much an incoming coach with 10 years of coaching experience should make visually and algebraically. Well, we aren't doing anything algebraically. All of ours is visual. So if I'm looking at 10 years of experience, here is my 10 years. I'm going to physically draw on my graph all the way up to my line. I can even take my ruler and I can draw across. And we can say, you know, call it about $2,100 for their salary. That's probably per month. So the trend line's purpose is to help us make predictions. Down here we have another question. Use the trend line to determine how much a coach should make when he's accumulated 25 years of experience. So again, look at your label, make sure you're in the right spot. 25, we could extend it out if we needed to. This could extend our line. This is one where really the equation is going to be much better and we can use it. We could say maybe about 4,000. You're not going to have any that far off that you can't see what's happening. So let's come over here and look at this next one. This one is Isle Royale population. So wolves and moose population. population. And what kind of correlation do we see? Well, this is a linear negative correlation. And let's go ahead and draw our trend line. So if this is negative, we need to try to go through a couple of different thoughts about the bad. And everybody's trend line is going to be a little different because you're going to estimate it different. So if you didn't get yours right or mine, that's okay. Use the trend line to determine how many moves would remain if there were only four moves. So four moves, look at your scale. The scale here is counting by one, but on the y-axis is counting by 100. So I'm going to go up four moves and over two moves. I'm not sure what the four moves is. And we can say about 500 moves, maybe a little bit higher. And could be this next question. Use the trend line to determine how many moves would essentially wipe out the moose population. So that means the moose is equal to zero. Well, that's going to be way down here. And remember, this is counting by one. So 26, 27, 28. By my line, it is about 29 moves. But again, your line might be a little different, so we can estimate as long as you're around that number. And that is the purpose of a trend line. So we're going to practice that some more tomorrow.